is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Dave in Clearwater. Hey, Dave, Happy New Year. What's happening, man?
Happy New Year to you, my brother. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
I am doing well, man. I'm doing well. Can I throw a quote out at you?
Sure.
In the market, somebody knows something. Someone always knows something. That statement was made by a great trader by the name of Tom O'Brien about 6-7 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And it kind of hit me like a brick. You're right. Somebody always knows something.
Hey, Carlos, what's going on, brother?
I'm calling you back, Tom. This morning, I had the pleasure to talk to you and your son, and I don't want to miss the opportunity to talk to you again.
Well, I think you made some money on this bond.
Oh, yes, Tom. Your newsletter helped me.
That's a beautiful thing. We appreciate the growling problem with us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome. It's Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. To begin a great relationship, know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women. Some of them will make a good match for you and others won't. The two of you only need to be like a key to lock, a match that works. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 34, NASDAQ up 4, S&P's up 1, gold contract down $6.40, trading at $12.06 an ounce. Silver, flat at $17.14 an ounce. Platinum, down $11 at $9.64 an ounce. Copper, down a penny at $2.61 a pound. Light sweet crude off $1.27, trading $51.21 a barrel. Notes, the 10-year note, down 22 ticks, 124.17. 30-year bond down a full point and 18 ticks at 151.23. King dollar up 830 ticks, trading at 101.150. The euro is at 106, and the yen is trading at 114.07. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You have a sideways day out here, folks. The volume is anemic. It's going to be really interesting. This could be one of the smallest volume days of the year, which is going to be pretty wild watching this thing shake out. We've done 33 million shares on the SPY right now. You know, we went downtown yesterday with 61 million, and that was anemic, by the way, okay? We went uptown the day prior to that with 62 million. It looks like market's waiting for the inauguration. That's how this seems to be shaking out. If we take a look at the indice volume in the NYSE, we're only at 463 million. That same will come in about 650. We go over to the NASDAQ. We take a look at the NASDAQ. The NASDAQ's at 1.2. That's going to come in about 1.5. The Qs. We go take a look at the Qs, what you have with the Qs out here. The Qs have done 8.9 million. You went down yesterday with 14. We had made the high 2 days ago at 16. You're going to do like 11. It's pretty wild what's happening out here. Okay, so we did the S&Ps. We go into the NASDAQ composite next. We take a look at the composite. Composite right now, you get a sideways move. You're at 5542. Bottom line, that you get the high out there, 5584. You get light volume, yeah, you can get tested again. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold contract right now is trading at a price point of 1206. You're down 690. You've reached a high today of 1217. You're doing 174,000 contracts, so you're backing down with dramatically lighter volume. We went topside yesterday, pushing swing points with 381,081,000 contracts. You're backing down at 174. Silver, same type of setup in silver. What you have with silver is this. Silver right now is trading at a price point of $17.14. Okay, now silver's going to be different because silver made another high. Silver got to a price point out here of $17.36. We did 52,000 contracts. That hasn't held price. So silver at $17.14, that can get into maybe $17. Now, That being said, what you're still doing inside that silver market, let's see, 63,000, that's not bad. So you're going into 63,000, we've done 52 thus far. Bottom line, that's building cause for higher price. Now, let's go into the notes and bonds, because they're saying quite a bit. And what are they saying? Now, you get the notes down 21.6. We've done 1.1 million contracts. Well, guess what, folks? That is a pullback on dramatically lighter volume. And you get fast price destruction without volume. You're coming into 1.8 million contracts. You're coming into 1.58 million contracts. That's still saying that notes want higher price. Now, we go over to the bond market. We take a look at bonds. Bonds are down more than a point and a half. Well, you're down exactly a point and a half right now. You've done 196,000 contracts. 196,000 contracts right here are coming into 338,000 contracts as well as 287. So you can see that correlations. The correlations are pretty intense, meaning that you have price destruction, you have no volume. That's saying notes and bonds still want higher price. King dollar. Let's go over to King dollar. What do you have with King dollar? King dollar is up today 840 ticks. You've done 35,000 contracts. This is setting up a nice ABC structure on the way down. Bottom line, and this could be a good one too, meaning a large one. You know, you go right to the top for the A point, which would be 103.81. When we came down, you know, you came down on 74,000 contracts. We came down on 61 yesterday. You're going up on 35. It's a nice setup. Just before we get on, Yellen is speaking. And that was when Yellen was speaking, the dollar index just went from 100.880 to 101.125, to right where it is right now. And what she was talking about is that she felt, let me get the, let's see, that's the beige book. That's not, Yellen felt that the dual mandate of the Fed is there right now, meaning it's getting achieved, and she did not know when the next rate hike would be. Here, I have it right here. Okay. So Federal Reserve Janet Yellen said the U.S. economy is close to the central bank's objective of full employment and stable prices, and she's confident that we'll continue to improve. It is fair to say that the economy is near maximum employment. Inflation is moving towards our goal, Yellen said in a text of a speech Wednesday to the Commonwealth Club in San Francisco. While it makes sense to gradually reduce the level of monetary policy support, the timing of the next interest rate increase will depend on how the economy actually evolves in the coming months. 877-927-6648. We go and we take a look at the XAU, the HUI. XAU out here trading at 87.63. This little baby, let's pull this up because I believe you're going to see yesterday you had volume out here, 45 million. You're going into 57, so that does need some more juice when we're eating into the November 9th, 10th downdraft. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are down 34. You get the NASDAQ up 5. S&Ps are up 1.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's take a look at some of the high-volume stocks in this low-volume market. And go back. We'll go right into the S&P and take a look at this. You have Bank of America up 46 cents. You got Ford down 22. Apple is up 16. We have Nvidia up $1.18. Tiger is getting toasted out here. That's down $4.12. Some of the Dow stocks. You have ExxonMobil off $1.13. Ma Bell is down 25 cents. Big Blue's off $1. You get Johnson & Johnson down 24. You get 3M up 132. JP Morgan is up 27. Let's go over a couple of the financials. JPM, because what we had out here yesterday is this. They came out with numbers. They sold off with some volume on the way down. Now I suspect we're going to get probably a small countertrend bounce. And how we bounce is going to be crucial to understand. Do these things want higher price? Are they setting up a small ABC down? Like with the JP Morgan, you're at 83, 87. It looks to me like it wants to run to this 80, 44, but I expect you're going to see a bounce first. If we go to the XLF, we take a look at that whole sector. You'll see the sector rejected lower price out here today. It's going to have lighter volume. So now the kick is going to be, how does it trade into the 2331 area? Right now you're 2312. That's going to be really crucial to take a look at. Cameco, if you want to see something, Cameco Corporation, that when equities finish ABC structures on the way up or the way down, you got to be careful, folks. Bottom line, this Cameco has had an amazing run. You went from $7.71 up to 13.36. Now, what it had done, it done a couple ABC structures on the way up. We caught a good amount of this and got out at about the $11 area. Then it launched again. It launched on the 10th of January. Within 3 days, it finished another ABC up. And guess what? It finished that ABC up, so it was that was a double ABC up after consolidation. And then, bah, boom, this thing came down hard today. It's down $2.47. You're at 1080, and don't touch this thing because you have two different things that end up happening. When you come off a high like this with this type of volume, this thing's going to go get to lower price. They came out today, and they put a kibosh on their equity as well as uranium in general. Bottom line is that they, let's see what they had to say. They're saying, excuse me, folks, they're out here this morning. Bottom line, saying they're going to make less money. That's what it really comes down to. So, you know, this thing will have a deeper, much deeper retracement. And if we take a look at this, let me pull this back a bit. Whew, wow. Yeah, this thing can pull all the way back to 910 now pretty easily, too. Right? We'll see where it shakes out, but it's a big number. Inside the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness out here this morning, or this afternoon, rather. You have Fastenal is the leader. That's up 5.3%. CTXS, Citrix System, is up 2.8%. Avco Technology, which is Broadcom, is up 2.8%. And Skyworks is up 2.7%. On the way down, you have CSX Corporation, which is the railroad. That's down 3%. NetEase is down 3.2%. Dentist Supply is off 2.8%. And Dollar Tree is down 2.7%. If we go over to the XLE, well, actually, let's go into the oil market first. So because it was a holiday on Monday, what we're going to have, you're going to have oil numbers and gas numbers out tomorrow morning. Normally, oil numbers are on 10:30 on Wednesday. Gas is 10:30 on Thursday. What we're going to have is gas will come out at 10:30 on Thursday. Oil will come out at 11 o'clock on Thursday. If we go up and we take a look at the oil contract, what you're going to see is that we got inside the lower range yesterday. It failed on price and volume. It came back inside the range. And what we have out here today, oh, this is going to get cool, man. Okay, so check this out. Just as the market has light volume, this is dramatically light volume. Okay, so this is going to be wild. This is going to be great. Yeah, because oil numbers are coming out. Okay, so we're down $1.24. You have 216,000 contracts trading. You're going into, this needs a lot more contract volume in order to break this 50.71. Right now you're at 51.24. Let me make sure I get the most liquid contract though. What happens with oil, folks, is that there we go, okay, hold it. Because what happens with oil is that oil swaps out every month, folks, versus 3 months. So there's a lot of contracts go, oh yeah, oil's in trouble, forget it. So this contract, you're coming down on 530,000 contracts. You're coming into 278,000, 5165. Okay, so we're at 5205. 5165 is the thing to keep your eye on. But the way this is coming into that, that's telling me we're going to break down. Let's go to the USO because with USO. We take a look at the USO, that is down, that's a toss up too. So that's only down to 23 million, you're coming into 32. Can't hold price, $11.16. You know, it should get some support at 11.10. You know, we'll find out the next hour and coming into tomorrow morning. But bottom line is that you're in the lower range right now inside that contract. We go up and we take a look at the XLE, the oil and gas equities, and this thing tried to get to a higher high today, failed on price, failed on volume. That's saying that it's going to try to now fill that gap. There's a big gap in the XLE, and that is left over from the 29th of November. 29th of November, we closed at $70.83. The following day, you opened at $73.29. That's a heck of a gap, man. That is one big gap. It's going to go after the bottom of that gap. So the first place I suspect it's going to go after is 73.29. Big number. And coming up, let me get this right in front of us here. So if you come over to our website, folks, at TFNN, what you're going to see in the very front is a live event. I'm going to be doing a live event. This event is going to be a week from tomorrow, January 26th. It's going to be on a lesson in trading the nugget in the dust. The nugget and the dust, each one of them are the direction 300% bull or bear positions. This is a free workshop, folks. I know how many folks, how many calls we get in, how many people trade the leverage products. So you want to understand these leverage products and really, you know, I know I say many times, and I've been saying it for years, please come over, read the white papers. We're going to break it down within an hour so you can really understand what happens and how these leverage products are set up, number one, and then how I like to trade the nugget in the dust and what I'm looking for. So the inside that lesson what we're going to have is this. We're going to talk about the composition and the mechanics of leverage ETFs, daily rebalancing, compounding, and then we're going to talk about what happens when markets rise steadily, what happens when they decline steadily, and then what happens when they're flat but volatile. So that section there has everything to do with leveraged ETFs. Then we're going to get into the aspect of the dust and the nugget. Well, we're going to be talking about that, of course, the whole time. Then we're going to talk about where's the dollar trading and what are the equity weightings of the dust and the nugget, so you have a better understanding of what the weightings are and what you should be looking for when you're either trading them on the bull side or the bear side. Right on the front page of TFNN, folks. We'll be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials right now down 35. You get the NASDAQ up 7. S&P's up 1.5. Gold's down 1080. And if you want to see a correlation, folks, which is really cool, you know, we talk about this a lot. It's the correlation between the yen and the gold contract. If you happen to be watching Tiger TV, what you're going to see is that this is a live feed, and I have the gold contract and the yen up on the same chart. And what you're going to see is that as the yen gets stronger, so since the Yellen has been talking, bottom line, the yen has got stronger, gold has got weaker. It's pretty amazing just watching this whole context, particularly when you're putting it on the exact same chart. I mean, it's about as clear as you can get. So that's something that if you do trade inside that metals market, you want to know where that yen's going at all times. Bottom line is that we'll see where this shakes out. If I go over to the dollar index and we take a look at this, the dollar index to me is still a very large ABC structure on the way down. It's a beauty too, because you're bouncing on 37,000 contracts. But pretty cool when you set that up. And the feed that you were just looking at there, by the way, was a 10-minute intraday feed. And that's actually the first time I did that on a 10-minute intraday feed. And it's the correlation is just crazy, man. So evidently there's definitely large traders that is their hedge. That's how they're trading that out, trading one for the other. Because there must be more than a few of them, too. That's how it's shaken out. We go up and we take a look at the, let's see. So we had Goldman Sachs. Goldman Sachs came out with numbers this morning. Numbers were good. Bottom line, can't hold price. And you still have volume. Pretty amazing, okay? So this is what you have. Volume out here today is 6.6 million shares. Yesterday did 6.2. It was selling down even before the numbers. You're down $1.51. I'd love to see some kind of a bounce on this, because this is setting up, if it bounced, it'd be setting up a nice ABC structure down. It looks to me like Goldman wants to trade down to the 204 level, and right now we are at 234, so you're talking about big numbers. Citigroup also come out with numbers this morning. They were good numbers. Best, guess what? Bottom line, market's selling them off with volume. Citigroup wants to trade down to this 54 level. We are at 57.33 right now. And what we do have is this. This is, now, this happened yesterday, and it's happening now. I haven't found, well, actually, hold on, let me do this. NVDA. Yesterday, what had happened, yeah, and NVDA doesn't have volume. Okay. So what had happened yesterday is this. We had light volume in the marketplace, excluding the XLF. The financials had volume. They went down. They went down with volume, okay? The whole rest of the market, folks, had light volume. Today, with the volume, is really light. It's unbelievable, actually. You know, it's unbelievable normally for a day that you'd think that you'd get some volume. But it looks to me that the market now is waiting for inauguration. We're so close to it. You're talking about Friday, you know? So Friday, bottom line, the signature's going to be out there, and this market right now is waiting to figure out what's going on. Because what we did have out here, now this was a curveball to the Canadian currency. What had just happened at one of the confirmation hearings this morning is that, I think it was Ross, I got to find out who this was. What had happened is that the market absolutely knew that the NAFTA agreement, okay, bottom line, is on the table, okay? So, you know, that agreement there, okay, not the NAFTA agreement, an open tradable policy with Mexico was going to basically slow down, or Trump would try to do whatever he could do to slow that down dramatically. What wasn't, it seemed, at least I didn't see it, and the market didn't see it, on the table, is that the whole NAFTA agreement, but that's going to be our neighbors to the north, Canada, okay? So what ended up happening is that, yeah, it was Wilbur Ross. When Wilbur Ross was speaking about 2 hours ago, that came up, and bottom line, he is saying that, yeah, I'm going to go talk also to the other side of our border. And what that did, that threw a loop into the Canadian dollar in about a heartbeat, and it weakened it. You know, the Canadian dollar, the peso had been getting weak. The Canadian dollar had been getting strong, was on a tear. The Canadian dollar had just gone from 135 down to 130. Now, bottom line is that you're back at 132 and a half right now. So that is a new development that's on the table, and I'm sure brothers and sisters up in Canada are going to be scratching their head right now, because it's all on the table. That's what it really comes down to. So that open border up there, we'll find out how much how open that is going to be also. If we go take a look at the small caps out here, this is what you have inside the small caps. Small caps right now, the IWM, you get a sideways move, dramatically lighter volume, same type of setup. You're 15.7 million shares. And, you know, we need a good 40, 50 million in order to get the lower price. I mean, the IWM looks like it's set up to get down to the 127. The real key is going to be, you know, what will be that catalyst in order to get it down into that levels. You know, we do have option expiration this Friday, so we'll see where that whole thing shakes out. Hey, we'll find out whether they get the volume in the marketplace. You know, it looks to me, with the type of volume that we have in here today, it's almost telling me tomorrow that it's even going to be lighter. You know, because if the market is waiting to see exactly how many executive orders get signed or where they're going to get signed on Friday afternoon, that would bring you into next week as to where the real action is going to be. And then what we also have is that each and every day that we get closer to the 26th, which is a week from tomorrow, bottom line, the more earnings are coming out. Okay, so next week, they really start. On the 26th, you have a huge amount of earnings coming out. And from that point on, actually even just next week, they start like a locomotive, and then they really just keep going. So there's going to be a lot of action out here in those markets. If we go over to the platinum market, we take a look at platinum. Now, what platinum had done, platinum was giving it back. PLAT, let me see this. Even with gold and silver up, platinum couldn't catch a bid. Now, it was certainly ahead of itself, meaning that it had got up and into the November 9th and 10th level. Wrong one. It's not F, PLH, let me see. Let's do this one. No, it's not that either. Bottom line is that the platinum is pulling back. And that started a pullback right before gold and silver the last couple days. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials down 28. NASDAQ up 9. S&P's up 3. We're going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 27. You get the NASDAQ up 11. S&Ps are up 3. Let's go take a look at Netflix, NFLX. So Netflix at 5 past 4 today are going to come out with their numbers. Netflix is trading at $132, and let's take a look at this baby. So, where is good old Netflix want to go? Okay, let's take a look at this. So, oh man, this is a trip. Okay, so we are right at highs. Look at this. Holy cow. Okay, so I just brought this back 2 years. I'm going to bring it back 4 years. It doesn't matter. 2 years is the best one. Okay, so on a two-year chart, what you have is this. Your first high was achieved August of 2015. That was $129.29. We did 108 million shares. You did a retracement after that to 85. You came back up. So that's, let's see, August of 2015. So 8:15. Okay. You come back up and you tested that area, an exact area, and December of 2015, you hit a price point of 133. You did 89 million shares versus 108. It couldn't handle it. So it went from 133 down to 79. It took... So that's December 2015. We got back up there in October of 2016, 129.29. We did that with 124 million. So that's a good number. And then we did 33 million last week. That's nothing. And the week before we did 38. Okay, so that's setting up that it wants to pull back on these numbers. Now that's in the weekly, so I'm gonna do this on the monthly because the monthly is gonna give us a clearer picture too of how it hit the highs and the volume. Okay, so here we go. On the monthly, this is what you have. Oh, this is pretty cool. Okay, so let's check it out. On the monthly, 831. Okay, so eight, we did 469 million. That's 8 of 15. We tested it 12 of 15, and we did that on 320 million. So you can see what happened there. You did it on dramatically lighter volume, and it couldn't handle it, so it went down from 133 to 79. We came back up in October with 274. Which is still dramatically lighter. In November, we did 128. Okay, so when you put those together, this is going to be pretty cool watching this thing shake out. When you put this together, that's saying that Netflix is going to do a pullback. Now the question is going to be, like, how far is this baby going to pull back? Because that's an anemic test, by the way, folks. I mean anemic. You can pull back to $97 in a heartbeat. This is going to be wild watching this thing shake out. I love it when these things are coming right out. And Netflix has a 5.7% shot interest. So that's not a big shot interest at all. And they've been growing by leaps and bounds. So that's going to be 4:05 that number's going to come out. Let's go to Brent in Martinez, California. Hey, Brent, what's going on?
I'm doing well, Tom. How are you today?
Good, man. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
I had a couple I was hoping you could look at. The first one, I am long at 844, and I do have some options on it, and that's Nordic American Tankers. It's having a pretty good day today.
Let's take a look.
I like that it was basing for about a month, and it's starting to come out of that, and so it looks decent.
Okay, so let's take a look. You got NAT. This is Nordic American Tankers, and as Brent had just said, these things, you got to have patience because they love to base, and then when they move, man, they move. So I can see what he was looking at even prior to that, folks. He had seen that it came off the lows on November 9th, got up to 936, then got to 960, had 5.4 million, 5.1, then pulled back with 1.3. Yeah, you get action there, man. I mean, I suspect you're going to get a test of at least 960, because you got the juice there. Let me just put this on a weekly for a second. Yeah, 960's game, man. 995's game. I can see that, too. Yeah.
Yeah, it's acting pretty well. And then the other one I was hoping you could look at is, which I don't own yet, but it looks like it has some potential on the buy side if it gets down to my target's about 156, is IPI, Intrepid Potash, whenever you're done looking at that one.
IPI, Intrepid Potash. Okay, let's take a look at it. So, this is in the potash business.
Had a couple signs of strength. It's pulling back because if it gets down to that level, that would be a 618 retracement of the whole move from, I think it was like 65 cents up to 304. And then it also would be it's kind of doing an AB equals CD down to, if it can do it, it would be down at that level. So, and I don't know if it will, but that's there that I would buy it if it got down there.
Let's take a look. Oh, look at this thing. Man, oh man, holy cow. So this equity, folks, November 29th, it's at $1.22. 5 days later, it's at $3.04. Wow. Okay. Listen, just wait for it to come back. It's going to come back, man. What happens is this. When you go up like this parabolic, folks, you can see that it based out after it went up from December 7th until yesterday. And then once it's below that, it's just like there's no floors, man. So, if you could get this thing at $1.47, it'd be awesome, man. Pull this back. And that was interesting. So this was also, 255, 304. That's good. So watch what this did also, folks. This is, now, when you come off a bottom, when it went up in December from 138 to 304, it also took out a little tiny swing point. Now, that, folks, is important to wrap your head around because what does happen is this. When stocks get destroyed like this, and this equity certainly, got destroyed. It went from a price point of $70, I think $74 or something, down to pennies probably, right? Yeah, 65 cents. If they don't take a swing point out, when they're bouncing, they can go out of business. It doesn't matter. Even if I've seen, Brent, if you have strength off lows, like as stocks that get destroyed, but they haven't taken a swing point out, it doesn't mean a thing. This means something because it finally took out, even though it's a small one, guess what? It took out a swing point, man. So this is game. Yeah, you get game there, man.
Yeah, look interesting. All right, I really appreciate it, Tom. You just have a great day, and I'm sure we'll talk soon.
Awesome, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. We got the Dow right now, folks. Down 23. Nasdaq's up 14. Xilinx, XLNX. This is also going to come out with numbers after the close. They're not saying exactly when. Xilinx usually comes out pretty quickly, though, after the close. That is trading at 57.90. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. If you'd like to come to the free webinar I'm going to be doing on the dust and the nugget, folks, come over. And if you trade any of leverage products, folks, you want to be to this webinar, it's free. Go to the front page of TFNN. It's a week from tomorrow, 6 to 7 Eastern Standard Time. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletter. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. The hard Brexit here is going to get interesting, folks, because what you do have is that these banks, it looks like they're going to be basically pulling out of the city of London. It looks like they might be doing it pretty quick. Goldman Sachs, this is considering cutting its London staff to 3,000 with transfers to New York and the European continent. Citing unidentified people in the financial industry. They may transfer up to 1,000 of them to Frankfurt, including traders and top managers in regulation and compliance. Investment bankers for French and Spanish clients would move to those countries. Back office people would move to Warsaw. That's pretty intense. That's if those banks are moving out of the city of London, you're going to see some real estate go down pretty quickly. And, you know, what does happen in the city of London, however, though, you know, it's almost like Miami, folks. You can get a crash coming in and then give it 4 or 5 years and the thing comes right back and then roars up again. You know, so because that what you do have in London and Singapore, you certainly have huge financial capitals that, you know, finance just doesn't die. gets whipped around a bit, but bottom line doesn't die. And I suspect once they turn around and make trade deals with those countries, it's going to make a difference. So we'll see where that whole thing shakes out. If we actually go over and we take a look at the DAX right now in Germany, because that would be the winner. It would seem like that out of Goldman Sachs, that's the winner. They had 4,000 people. They were going to get rid of 2,000? Let's see. Let me just see that again. They had Goldman Sachs had GS. Okay, so they're cutting. Yeah, they were cutting 50% of their staff, and okay, so they're cutting 3,000, and Frankfurt was maybe getting 1,000. So that's a big number. Cutting 3,000 is no doubt is a big number. And folks, if you would like to come to the workshop I'm going to be doing on the nugget in the dust and leveraged ETFs, come over to our website at TFNN. All we need is your name and your email. You'll be into the workshop. This workshop is going to be January 26th, 6 to 7 Eastern Standard Time. Now, if you can't make it live, we'll put it on your page for a full month. I'm going to be talking about the composition and mechanics of leveraged ETFs, how daily rebalancing works, what compounding does to these structures, what happens when the market rises steadily, what happens when it declines steadily, what happens when the market is flat but volatile. Then we're going to talk about how you want it to be trading the dust in the nugget, meaning that where's the dollar going? What do you think the dollar is doing? And then what are the weighting structures inside of that so you can get a better understanding, looking at 10 of the largest equities that are inside the nugget in the dust and get a feeling as which way you think those are going. So if you'd like to come to that workshop, really get to understand those vehicles, check it out on the front page of TFNN. It is a week from tomorrow at 6 o'clock at night. Coming up today, we'll have Netflix and Xilinx come out with the numbers. Tomorrow morning, we get Alaskan Air coming out. You get BB&T. We get J.P. Hunt. You get Western Alliance, Bancroft. And then after the close tomorrow, we get American Express, Maximum Integrated, and United Continental. As we kick into the next few days, you're going to get five or six of these every day in the morning and the afternoon. As we kick into next week, you're going to get some big numbers. No two ways about that. The 26th is one of the biggest days for all the tech stocks. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back with some numbers for you. We have the Dow Industrials down 24. The NASDAQ is up 16. S&Ps are up 4. We are going to be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following is a presentation of TFNN.
The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Marty in Worcester. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hi, Mr. O'Brien. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you been, man?
Not bad.
Good.
In fact, you know, you guys, over the time and with a few of your courses and seminars, you know, you taught me how to fish.
That's a beautiful thing, brother. That's so cool.
Right, yeah, it's true. And so what happens is I still listen all the time, and to not only you, but some of the others.
Sure.
To, you know, get an idea where the fish might be biting.
Yeah.
But as far as your services, they're a bargain. When you compare them to a certain prominent man with real estate courses at $35,000 and no contact with the lecturers afterwards at all, and you think of what you guys do for a few hundred, and you can get access and ask questions forever, you know, it's a great deal.
No, we appreciate the growling problem with us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Wow! Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We are 5 days a week. We are 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Love is unconditional. In love, there are no conditions. You love for no reason, with no justification. You are free to be who you are, and you allow others to be what they are. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 22, NASDAQ up 16, S&P's up 4.5, gold contract down $8.90, trading at $12.04 an ounce. Silver down 6 cents at $17.08 an ounce. Platinum off $12.50 at $9.63 an ounce. Copper down a penny at $2.61 a pound. Light sweet crude down $1.17, trading at $51.31 a barrel. We're going to get the oil numbers out tomorrow. We'll get the actually AP numbers out actually in the next half hour. Oil numbers don't normally come out on Wednesday with the holiday. We're going to have gas numbers at 10:30 tomorrow. Oil numbers at 11 o'clock. Bonds, you get the 10-year note, down 27.6, 124.13. 30-year bond off a full point, plus 25 ticks, 151.17. Now, those are big numbers, folks. So we came down hard in the notes and the bonds, and guess what? Dramatically lighter volume. So you had a fast crush on price, no volume. That says you're going to go right back topside. They were selling off all day long. Then Yellen came on with a speech. And inside that speech, she said she felt that the Fed was near their long-term goals, meaning that the full employment and their inflation targets. And, of course, what that would mean is that, guess what? That would mean that higher interest rates. She also came out and said that they didn't have a timeline for that. King dollar up 945 ticks, 101.265. That's a nice bounce on King dollar, but guess what? King dollar, no volume on that bounce. King dollar looks like it's setting up a large ABC structure on the way down. The euro is trading at 106, and the yen is trading at 114.58. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have out here? Okay, so S&P, the SPY out here today was up 50 cents. You're trading at 226.75. You did volume of 50 million. It's anemic volume. Yesterday we came down with 61. That was anemic volume. You went up the prior day with 62. Bottom line, you're 226.75. That's saying that the 227.40, the highs of on Friday, want to get tested. Dow Industrials. What do we have inside the Dow Industrials? Dow Industrials sideways move. Well, actually, no. Dow Industrials rejected lower price. And had dramatically lighter volume. So let me look at this for a second. So you got 771 million. Yesterday it did 900 million, 771. That's saying that once again, Dow Industrials are going to make a run. I don't necessarily think the 20,000's in play, but of course, what we have hit, and that we hit that on the 6th of January, we hit 19,999.63. Have to love that, man. First, NASDAQ Composite. What do we have with the Composite? Composite is closed at 5555.656. I like that one. Composite is game to, you know, go after a tie once again, which is the 55584. And the X100, the three Qs. Inside the three Qs, three Qs closed at 123.04, and they had light volume, 12.2 million. Right now, they should be trading up a little because Netflix come out with numbers. So we're trading at 123.13 right now. NFLX, Netflix come out with numbers. Netflix closed at 133. That's trading at 143. So that'll send a little juice into the composite. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract. Gold contract trading down 880. You did 190,000 contracts. Bottom line, you pull back with dramatically lighter volume. That's saying gold still wants higher price. What we did out here, we pulled back into 381,000. You did 190, and you're also pulling in back into 329,000 contracts. Silver, same type of setup as gold. Pull back, dramatically lighter volume on the pullback. Silver. So what silver did is this. Silver actually got to a higher high. Excuse me, folks. So silver, you know, we got to price point of $17.36. We're trading 17.09. It's trying to bust over the high of the December 14th. You know, silver's much weaker than gold. You know, gold is already up at the November 10th and November 11th area inside the chart. That would bring silver up to $19. So what I expect to see in silver can back down to like $16.90. Nothing heavy. King dollar. Oh, actually, let's go take a look at the notes first. So, excuse me. You had the notes come down with price destruction. 25 ticks in the 10-year, that's a big number. 32 ticks, remember, is a full point. It's very unusual when the 10-year does a full point. We did come down on 1.2 million contracts. You're coming into 1.8 million contracts, as well as 1.5. So it's going to need a lot more contract volume to break down. We go take a look at the 30-year. 30-year also came down hard, full point, plus 21 ticks. That came down on 217,000 contracts. You're coming into 338. You're coming into 301. King dollar. This is the number, folks. Good old King dollar. So King dollar goes up 935 ticks. You're at 101.255. You did volume out here of 38,000 contracts. You're going into 61,000 contracts as well as 74,000. That looks to me like A to B, and we'll see of an ABC structure on the way down. We'll see where the C is going to line up. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished down 22. NASDAQ up 16. S&P's up 4. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you?
Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Netflix. Netflix come out with numbers. Netflix closed at 133. It's trading 143. It's been as high as 145. I've seen as high as 145. Let's see what they have to say out here. So Netflix signed up a record 7.05 million new customers in the fourth quarter. It's a big number. Top in analyst estimates for domestic and international growth to cap the company's first year as a global online TV service. The company added 5.12 million new customers in international markets, according to the statement, beating analyst estimates of 3.78. So the estimate was 3.78. They came in with 5.1. Netflix also signed up 1.93 new domestic customers, U.S. customers. Their projection was, they're exceeding projections of 1.38 million. Fourth quarter sales rose 36% to $2.47 billion from a year earlier. Earnings grew to 15 cents a share from 10 cents a share, beating the estimate of 13 cents. Netflix predicts it will sign up 1.5 million new domestic streaming subscribers in the first quarter, while analysts are projecting a 1.72. International subscribers will grow 3.7. The company said the analyst estimates is 3.5. First quarter earnings will be $165 million or 37 cents a share. A big first installment on founder and chief executive officer Reed Hastings vowed to deliver material profit in 2017. The company, the world's largest paid video service, bet its future on globally replicating its success in the U.S., where it has almost 50 million customers. That's pretty amazing. There's like 300 million people in the United States, 330 or something. They get 50 million customers. Sacrificing near-term profit while spending heavily on programming and marketing to build a global TV network. Hastings still has a long way to go. While Netflix has signed up almost half the available market at home, it hasn't reached a percentage of broadband households and even the strongest foreign territories such as the UK and Canada. It will. That's the bottom line. So we're at 133. You're trading right now at 143. The thing that's going to be intriguing watching this, folks, is this, is that I brought this up at the last hour. So Netflix right now is up $10. You know, in October, bottom line, we came out with his numbers that had gapped from 98, gapped up to 119. Nice number. Now, when you bring this back and we put this on a monthly, what you're going to see is that you're pushing swings on dramatically lighter volume. So It looks to me like we're still, you know, we'll see if this holds the 133 tomorrow morning. But when we take a look at this on a monthly basis, this thing is teetering right now for a pullback. And it's this dramatic, too. So we did 128 million, and you're pushing into 320 million. Yeah. So, well, you know, bottom line, you can absolutely go higher with lighter volume. We all know that. Bottom line, it doesn't stay higher. That's how that shakes out. XLNX. Let's see if Xilinx came out with numbers yet. They're going to be coming out with numbers. Xilinx closed at 58.14, and that hasn't come out with numbers yet. Let's see. Let's make sure this is coming out today. Yeah, this says aftermarket. That's how this is shaking out. We take a look at some of the higher volume stocks, and this was a low volume market, no doubt. You had Bank of America up 58 cents. Ford Motor was down 20. We'll take a look at U.S. Steel. That was up 269. That's a big number. You had JCPenney down 13 cents. JP Morgan was up 39. NVIDIA is up 184. Let's go to U.S. Steel. Take a look at U.S. Steel. Okay, so this has been a heck of a run for U.S. Steel. U.S. Steel, November 2nd is at $17. Runs to 39, pulls back to 31, and now has strength out here today. Let's see what we have. Oh, I see what's going on. Okay. Oh, you got to love this. We should have known this anyway. So check this out. So, no, they didn't announce their earnings. What happened is this, though. You got to remember something, that Wilbur Ross made all his money in the steel market. And the way that it came down, folks, with Wilbur Ross, is that the companies, the steel companies were going bankrupt. He bought one of the large steel companies and then convinced the president at that point to put a TAF on steel within like 3 days. He made a fortune, billions of dollars. Ross out here was testifying today. He's going to be the Secretary of Commerce, and he was signaling that once again Chinese TAFs are going on, and I suspect that took it up in a big way. AKS, let's go take a look at this. That means they're all going to go. AKS went up 62 cents, and that's a $10 stock. So bottom line is that there's good. There's going to be winners. Well, there's always winners and losers. That's the real bottom line. The TAF situation is going to be a trip. What is really going to be a trip is to watch how this plays out. You know, when you hear the amount of TAFs that are going to be out there, when you hear the amount of goods that are either going to get stopped or going to get TAFed, the next question is, folks, you better watch your pockets. Because guess what? You're going to need more money in your pockets to start buying stuff. I mean, in a big way, too. So that's where this whole inflation thing is going to come. We've been so used to, so China really started pushing down inflation in 1982. You know, because 1982 really is, that's when China just started getting going. Shanghai, if you go look at pictures of Shanghai in 1982, it'll blow your mind as to what it looks then and now. So when you take a look at that ride started there. It started in Shenzhen, okay? That was one of the first big cities that opened, just kept going, going, going. All those goods are coming in. So instead of us paying more, goods just kept coming, moving lower, 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 right? You have the good, the bad, and the ugly, and all of that. There's no two ways about that. I'm not, you know, but what did happen is that quality of life-wise went up because we'd be paying less for many things that you actually need. Now, wages haven't gone up like they, you know, normally had gone up in the past. But the way this is getting set up is that we are going to have price rises. You know, because if TAFs go out there, guess what? Everything's going to cost more money. And, you know, we'll see where that shakes out. What I absolutely don't see is that when firms have protection, which we're talking about here. The thing that is blowing my mind about all of this is that supposedly Republicans are free traders. This is not free trading, folks, not even close. What it's going to be is protectionism. It's going to be certain companies are going to be protected. And then it's going to be, do those companies raise their prices to the highest level that they can within the context of still getting most of the business? And I expect they will, and I expect that they'll collude with other companies in that business, and we're all going to be paying a lot of money. But that this is only the beginning of, it's just not going to be trade wars. There's going to be trade wars, there's going to be financial wars, there's going to be pricing wars, because guess what? When everyone's pockets are getting hit, you're going to hear everyone yapping. We're going to be right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has put together the finest live programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 9 hours a day, starting at 8 a.m., as John Logan kicks us off each trading day with the Global Market Pulse. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour, following the Tom O'Brien Show. Mondays and Fridays, catch live trading on the Nadex platform with hosts Tom and Tommy O'Brien, along with Daryl Martin on the Bull Bear Binary Option Hour. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN show and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, a week from tomorrow night, if you'd like to come to a great workshop, if you actually trade or do have an interest in trading these leverage products, meaning the doubles or the triples, well, let's start with the people that do them right now. You want to be at this workshop. It's a free workshop. I'm doing the workshop on trading the nugget in the dust. That's the direction, 300 bull and bear positions inside the gold equity market. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right on the front page. It's January 26th. It's 6 to 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. If you can't make it live, folks, we'll put it on your page for a full month. Okay, so it's free. We just need your name, your email. We do not sell any of these names and emails, by the way. Okay, So check it out. It's going to be a great workshop. Bottom line, what I'm going to be talking about is the composition and mechanics of the leveraged ETFs, how daily rebalancing works, how compounding works. The compounding aspect, folks, it's when you see it on paper, you're going to really understand it. It's a lot easier seeing it versus walking through the math. You know, it's not hard math, but when you see it on paper, you're going to see how these things work. Specifically, how they work when markets go higher, and how they go higher steadily. And then I'm going to have an example of how they go lower steadily. And then I'm going to have an example of how they're, when they're flat but volatile. Then we're going to talk about specifically how to trade the dust and the nugget, meaning where's the dollar going, and what are the equity weightings inside the dust and the nugget. You know, when we talk about the equity weightings inside the dust and the nugget, what specifically what we're talking about is this, okay? And this is what's so cool, you know, and I'm not pushing you to trade either one of these vehicles. I just happen to like them. But when you're trading inside, the gold market is very small. So what happens is that inside the dust and nugget, these are the weighting structures. Now watch how this works out. You get Barrick gold, and these change every day. So it goes back and forth between Barrick and Newmont, who is the largest weighting, because it has to do with where that equity went, traded the prior day. Today, what you have is that Barrick is the largest weighting. That's 10.4%. Newmont's 9.7. Goldcorp, 6.7. Newcrest Mining is 6.6. Now, mostly everyone that's listening won't know Newcrest. Newcrest is a very large, one of the largest gold companies out there. It's an Australian company, though. But guess what? That weighting structure is 6.6 of the nugget or the dust. Franco-Nevada is 5.9, and Agnico Eagle's 5.4. Silver Wheaton's 4.4. Randgold is 4.2. Anglo Ashanti is 2.7, and Kinross is 2.4. What you can see there, if we just ballpark that, that's 20, 32, 42, 52. That right there is 60% of where the market's going to go. And you can see when you look at, if you just get the four big dogs down and you think and you have an idea where they're going to go, that gives you a much bigger probability as to where the nugget of dust would go. And then what you do specifically is that you're taking a look at the good old dollar and say, okay, talk to me, dollar. Which way are you going to basically go? So check it out on the front page of TFNN. It's next Thursday. It's 6 to 7 o'clock, and it's free. Inside the, so American Express, AXP, I think they're coming out with numbers after the close tomorrow. Yes. So American Express comes out tomorrow after the close, 16.05, 4.05. We closed at $77.49. And bottom line, that baby's closing up at its highs. Goldman Sachs come out with numbers this morning. They sold it right down again. They sold it down with volume, by the way. This is the second day they've sold Goldman down with volume. I'd love to see a dead cat bounce out of this, because a dead cat bounce would be a great thing to start selling some of these financials. Citigroup also come out with numbers. Numbers were all right in Citigroup. They sold that down with volume, 29 million shares. Morgan Stanley come out with numbers yesterday, and they were great numbers. This is good. I like it. So Morgan Stanley's setting up for lower prices. Morgan Stanley came down yesterday with 21 million. Up today in 15, you get a bounce going. You know, I suspect it can get a little bit higher. But Morgan Stanley gave us a huge amount of information in the banking sector yesterday, specifically that it had a great run. The numbers were big, though, and the funds still sold it off. So there was selling right across that financial sector yesterday. Bank of America up 58 cents today. You went downtown with 152 million. You're up with 124. This probably looks like it's going to retest again that high. You know, but you get a retest of that high, and if in fact we can get that, excuse me, folks, with dramatically lighter volume, that'll be a nice setup to sell the heck out of that. The commodity market out here today, you had natural gas down 2.8%. Gasoline was down 2.7. Heating oil was down 1.8. We had gold down 0.7%. Silver was off 0.4%. The only positives out here, you had sugar up 1.2%. Let me see the good old sugar market again. Sugar
This is pretty amazing that sugar is, sugar's trading at 20 cents a pound. Yeah, that's a big number, man. Sugar was 12 cents a pound in September of 2015. These commodities, man, when they move, they just move in a huge way. There's no two ways about that. Let's go see if Xilinx came out with numbers yet. They're coming out after the close. We'll just check. Nope, they haven't come out yet. So they are coming out. Well, they said they're coming out after the market. But after the market, on some companies, a long time coming, folks. That's how that shakes out. Tomorrow morning before the open, let's go take, you get a few of the airlines coming out. You get United Airlines coming out. So UAL is trading at 74 bucks. That's at highs. Let's pull this back. Some of this is going to be cool. So United Airlines has been trying to break a high from January of 2015. It's been trying to do it for 7 months. This is pretty cool. Okay, this is going to be great to watch. So we are at $74 flat out. The high from January of 2015 is $74.52. On a weekly, that was 28 million shares. Last week, we went into it with 17 million. Let's put this on a monthly. Yeah, United wants lower price. Okay, this is going to be cool watching this shake out. Okay, so check out what we have here. You have a doji high that was established in January of 2015. $74.52. excuse me, folks. 124 million shares traded. Even that wasn't enough volume because 2 months prior to that, it had 207 million. So 124 million, stock goes from $74 down to 37. Talk about a hit, right? Now what ends up happening? It's back to this level, and you're at 63 million on the monthly of December versus 124 million. That's saying that UAL is also going to go downtown. It's going to be pretty cool watching this thing shake out. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We go take a look at overseas. What we had last night in Asia, you had the Hang Seng up 1.1%. Nikkei was up 0.4%. Shanghai was up 0.3%. So if we let's go over the Nikkei first and take a look at the Nikkei. So the Nikkei is trading 18,894. This little baby is down from 19,600, and we're looking for here, because what you had is that as Janet Yellen was speaking this afternoon, you had that yen get stronger, which, you know, is an indication that bottom line is that that hurts the Nikkei in general. So Nikkei right now, a rejected lower price last night. Volume was light. Yeah, this can do a small bounce tonight. That's what it looks like. We go to the FTSE in the UK, what the UK did out here. Now, the FTSE, this baby is setting up a large ABC structure on the way down. This was a monster move, both in the pound and the FTSE in general. The FTSE had made a high on the 16th. It did that high with 643 million at 73.54, and then it came down with 900 million. Big number. Wasn't bad today, though. It's interesting. It went up with 820 today. Still looks like it wants to go to a lower price. So tomorrow is crucial inside the FTSE. The DAX in Germany, that's the DAX is one of the equities that you, I mean, the indices you want to watch like a hawk, folks. The main reason is that the a lot of the job structures, if in fact they get moved out of London, you know, a substantial amount of them will go to Frankfurt. And what you do have inside the DAX right now, that's trading at 11,599. Not near its high, that's for sure. The high, we'll get into this. So the high inside the DAX is 12,390. I see what we're doing. Okay, so we're coming into the downdraft from August of 2015. So August of 2015, this has to do some more work to make it through there. August of 2015, that's when the DAX had come off a high of 12,390 and then went down to 9,330. Long way down. It's going to have a long way making its way back topside. If we do go look at the XLF and the the XLF bottom line, this baby come down and did come down with volume. So it looks to me the financials want lower price. Now, what's going to be wild is this, folks, is that when you look at the financials and then you put this together with bonds, this is the bond market today got crushed on price. It didn't get crushed on volume. And this has been a one-way move coming off the bottom. We went, if we take a look at this, well, you had one way move both ways, actually. So
We had interest rates the day after the election, November 9th. The swing in the 10-year was dramatic. It was a 3-point swing, which is almost unheard of. They've been out there, but it's an outlier. We started out the day at 128.26. You went to 130.14, then down to 127. That started the downdraft that brought the 10-year from 130 all the way down to December 15th to 122.14. Now, what that did with the rates, with the 10-year rate, which we all want to always know where it is because that's where our mortgages are based on, that brought the 10-year rate up to 2.597 from about 2.2, okay? So from that low that was generated out here, 122.14, then the rate until this morning was 2.3. Okay, so now we're at 2.4. Now, when we take a look at this retracement-wise, we are just at a 0.32 retracement. You know, so that's a normal retracement in a market that wants to go higher. We'll see how it handles the 123.31, which would be another 13 ticks lower. That would be a 50% retracement. A 0.618 retracement would bring it down to 123.19. So that would be almost 27 ticks down. It would be 27 ticks down. It would be another day like today. So we'll see where that shakes out. Most times when you get a fast move lower on price and you don't have volume behind it, you're right back topside. So this is going to be a big number to keep your eye on, you know, because the correlation and what this is about is that you had Janet Yellen. Well, no, it's about we started out this morning. They were selling in the bonds anyway. Then what you had is that you had Janet Yellen speaking today. So here's one of the stories. The dollar rallied while treasuries plunged after Janet Yellen signaled that the Federal Reserve stands ready to raise interest rates if the economy strengthens as the central bank anticipates. The yield on the 10-year treasury note rose the most in a month, while the dollar spiked 1.1% after the Fed chair said the economy is close to the central bank's objective and she's confident it will continue to improve. Data showed a fifth straight monthly advance in the U.S. cost of living bolstered arguments that inflation is taking hold. Remember, they want inflation at 2% coming in the marketplace. The Fed remarks sent the S&P 500 to its session high. This is when it's a riot when you read some of these because it's like, okay, yes, it did send the S&P to its high, but guess what? The S&P was only up 2.7 points anyway. The Fed remarks sent the S&P 500 to its session high after it spent the afternoon fluctuating. The Mexican peso and the Canadian dollar tumbled after U.S. President-elect Donald Trump's commerce pick, this is Ross, said negotiating NAFTA will be a priority. The Canadian dollar did get whacked on the side of the head today, folks. So let me show you the difference between the Canadian dollar. You know, the peso has been getting hurt for a long period of time, particularly since the election. The Canadian dollar, however, was getting stronger. And what you had out here, what happened out here today, is that it just went the other way. And this was all about Wilbur Ross saying that no, NAFTA, you got to remember NAFTA, folks. NAFTA is Canada and Mexico. So, bottom line, at that hearing, you know, he wants to basically negotiate both of them. And that took the Canadian dollar from 130 to 132. And if we go take a look at this, so that, of course, makes it weaker. When you do look back here, the Canadian dollar was one. Let me pull this up. Yeah, so April of 2011, we were at 94 cents, strong like bull. Then we went up to 146 weak. That was January of last year. Now we're at 132. This is Tom O'Brien, this is TFNN. You stay right there, we come right back. And don't forget, over at our website, folks, the EverBank banner, you can open foreign currency accounts for as little as $100 and take advantage of the strong dollar.
Then we'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. And Netflix, let's go take a look at Netflix. Netflix come out with numbers, NFLX. They were up $10 earlier. You are still up $10. You're trading at $144. That closed at 133.26. I wouldn't be buying Netflix, by the way, not up here, because what you do have inside Netflix, growth, subscriber growth, everything's going great, folks. There's no two ways about that. Bottom line is that this is pushing highs, and the highs that we're talking about go back from August of 2015. This is the third time that we're up here, we came into this area with dramatically lighter volume. Netflix, for the month, would have to be pushing over 100 million in order to sustain price. And we pushed 38 million last month up at these 133 levels. So, yeah, they're going to push it up there, but I suspect it's not going to hang up there for long periods of time. What we are going to have coming out tomorrow morning is that you're going to have American Express coming out. American Express actually is after the close. Tomorrow morning, we're going to have Alaskan Air coming out, BB&T, J.B. Hunt, Western Alliance Corporation. After the bell, we're going to have American Express, Maximum Integrated, United Airlines. And now, here, let's look at United again, because United, actually, let's go look at Alaskan Airlines. Well, United, we're going to be able to trade, which is great. The problem is that Alaskan Airlines is going to come out in the morning, because United looks like it wants to go to lower price. And it's at highs, by the way. Alaskan Airlines also at highs. Now, oh, this is cool, though. This, and watch what the difference is. The difference is that Alaskan Airlines has volume at the highs. Oh, this is pretty cool. Alaskan Airlines is an ABC up. What a trip this is. So Alaska, 8 point is 69, the B 7091. So it's approximately $22, which would get you $108. So this is an ABC up. Yeah, it's a confirmed ABC up to $108. Let me see what's up here. Yeah, it's a confirmed ABC to $108. So here, watch what the difference is here. So Alaskan Airlines, that airline looks like it's doing fine. And I suspect the numbers are going to be good. They're expecting $1.8 billion to take in. You, United Airlines, just the opposite. So we'll be really cool about this, folks, if in fact Alaska goes higher and they take United up with it before they come out with the numbers. The reason being is that when you look at United, it's pretty dramatic. United, the swing high from January of 2015 is $74.52. We did $124 million, and we came into that last month with 63. That's a good number, man. That's a good number. That's saying, and when you take a look at the chart, the difference between Alaskan Airlines and United, it's pretty dramatic. And, you know, I can see that happening real easy. One of the main reasons, of course, is that the lots business, you know, economy's good. A lot of people coming in and out of the West Coast, in and out of Alaska, and they are basically growing pretty dramatically. And the cost structure is a pretty good cost structure. If you'd like to come to the webinar that I'm doing, folks, I'm doing a free webinar. If you do trade any of these leverage products, come on over, sign up. It's free. You just need your name and your email. It's going to be on the January 26th, 6 to 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. We're going to be talking about the nugget and the dust. We're going to be talking about how these leveraged ETF products work. You know, we get lots of calls here. I always ask everyone to come on over and, you know, read. And so if you want to get some good reading, too, by the way, even before this, go to ETFs at TFNN, read the white papers. You'll get a gist of what I'm going to be going over, so you'll really get to understand these things upside down. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Bam! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.